Learning to play any instrument can feel lonely, and even if you're like me and more on the introvert side, when you learn to play the harp on your own and there's no one to share this experience with, you may feel like you're losing your inspiration after a while. Hi there, I'm Zuzanna. I am a harpist and a harp teacher, but before that I was a student myself, and I know firsthand that even when you have a teacher and you can't discuss your progress with them, it can feel lonely when you're in between the sessions and you're just by yourself. And you may feel even more isolated when you're learning all on your own and it's just you and your harp. But when you have someone you can share this journey with, it can make all the difference. So grab your coffee or another favorite drink and let me tell you how a practice buddy could help you stay motivated and keep that creative spark that you're longing for. So who is this practice buddy? Practice buddy is someone you want to share part of your harp journey with. You help them and they help you to keep going and keep working towards your goals. Having said that, I feel like I should explain now who may not be the best practice buddy. You probably already share your journey in one way or the other with your family or friends. Most likely to them your harp always sounds lovely, or at least I hope so, but they may not quite understand your challenges or frustrations, even if they are trying to be as supportive as they can. If you are taking lessons, your teacher is likely very supportive and they understand very well what happens in your practice. But this doesn't really make them your practice buddy. This is because being a buddy is about giving but also receiving support. And even though teachers learn a lot from their students, this is not quite the same relationship. Besides, let's be honest, if you study with your teacher long enough, there may be lessons when things don't go as well as you were hoping for, and you will want to have a bit of a moan about this. And then you will likely prefer finding a friendly ear that is not attached to your teacher's head. Okay, that sounded weird. Let's move on. Someone who is in a similar place on this journey, maybe even at a similar level to yours, will be more understanding about how you feel, because they are right there, just like you. And maybe at this point you're starting to think about some of your harp friends that you may even already call your harp buddies. You may be meeting and sharing your harp news, and it's really nice to chat to them, but you're not quite sure how this has anything to do with your progress. That's because there is one more thing that you need, and that's for you both to check in with each other and agree to create this kind of more special relationship between you. You know, it's nice to have someone to share your ups and downs with every now and then, but even if it's someone you see regularly anyway, they may not always be ready to chat and listen to what you want to share. So it's important to check that you're both on the same page and that both you and them have this kind of space at this point of your lives to start supporting each other and, for example, have a longer chat once a week. When you're looking for a practice buddy and maybe reaching out to someone you don't know very well, your message could be something along these lines. Hello, I've been playing the harp for this long and I would say my level is this. I'm currently working on these pieces, here are the titles, and I'd love to find a practice buddy to stay on track with my goals and exchange a short message with progress update or get on a video chat. I'd like to get in touch about once a week, or your preference here, and I am based in this location or this time zone. Like we said before, as much as your friends and family are there for you to listen when you need them, they may not be able to understand everything that you'd like to share with them. Maybe they don't know what it's like to feel nervous when you play for someone, or why working on one of your pieces feels frustrating. And also, why do you even keep working on something that makes you feel frustrated in the first place? Also, because the harp is so different compared to other instruments, and I personally think that there are many aspects that make harp more challenging, some of these things may be really hard to understand when you talk to a non-harpist. Your practice buddy, though, will likely know these kind of challenges firsthand. Their story may be different to yours, but when you hear that someone has been through some similar experiences, you will feel less alone. Even though your practice buddy is not supposed to be your teacher, they may be able to share some ideas for solutions, or they could point you to resources that you didn't know existed. And if you get along well and you feel like you can trust them, you can even ask them for some feedback and give feedback to them. As you get to know each other and your relationship grows, eventually with time you will both learn how to tell that the other person may need some gentle nudge or encouragement to keep going. The best thing about it all is that you get to think about your practice goals, both short and long-term goals, and then you can plan together how you will get there. When you agree to get in touch regularly and share your plans, you can keep each other accountable and stay motivated together. Keeping in touch also means that you need to think through your short-term plans more carefully. As the famous quote goes, "We often tend to overestimate what we can do in a day and underestimate what we can do in a month. We overestimate what we can do in a year and we underestimate what we can accomplish in a decade." When you and your practice buddy agree that, let's say, every Monday you're going to share your goals for the week and then update each other about your progress, you both need to have a think about what smaller tasks you can work on over these few days. And even if you study with a teacher who gives you a certain amount of homework for the week, talking it through with a practice buddy can help you decide how you're going to organize your practice day by day. If the thought of sharing your weekly goals and progress sounds tempting, but you're not quite sure when you will be able to find a practice buddy to talk to, follow the link in the description of this video and join my free support group for Harp learners. Every Monday, there is a space to share your goals for the week and then to update others on your progress if you wish to. So if you're looking for some help with staying on track with your Harp practice and you want to give this whole idea a go, make sure you join us. And who knows, maybe you get to find your practice buddy in there. You'll find the link to the group in the description of this video. Now, I'd love to hear from you. Have you ever thought about sharing your Harp journey with someone? Do you have any questions about this topic? Do let me know in the comments. In the meantime, do make sure to subscribe Coffee Break Harp so you get notified about future episodes. I'll see you here very soon. Take care for now. Bye!